is an absolute madhouse here at PNC Arena tonight, the home of the North Carolina State Wolfpack, as the Pack tries to snap a long losing streak against the team their fans want them to beat more than anybody else, the Gang from Chapel Hill. Welcome to the Infinity College Basketball Tip-Off, and welcome to a very, very important game here in ACC country, the North Carolina Tar Heels, who have won three in a row against the NC State Wolfpack, who have lost two out of three since defeating then number one Duke 2 weeks ago. A look at the ACC standings. Well, as you look up, you got to look south. It's the Miami Hurricanes who lead the ACC. NC State at 4-2 and Carolina at 3-2. Hi, everybody. Dan Shulman and Dick Vitale. What a scene tonight here in Raleigh. What's at stake tonight?
Well, you know, I think bragging rights. I think a sense of pride. You just said it. They've lost 13 in a row to Chapel Hill. So now you got to play with some pride. A must win, your home floor. As recent guy said, if your goal is to win the regular season championship, you better win on your home turf. Lost to Maryland, lost to Wake Forest. You got to come to play like they did 2 weeks ago when they beat Duke. They haven't beaten Duke and North Carolina in the same year since 2003. Will it happen tonight, baby?
And as we mentioned, no love lost between the two programs. With more on that, here's Shannon Spate.
Well, Dan, one of the great things about rivalries is the bulletin board material that sometimes comes along with it. And today, we can thank Carolina's Dexter Strickland for this little gem. In a preseason interview, when asked about playing NC State, he said, they talk those guys up every single year, and we beat them every single year. They are the least of our worries. Beat us 1 year, and then they can talk smack. Until then, you can't put them in the mix. Of course, these two teams on the court here today, two very different teams than what we've seen in the past. Roy Williams in practice yesterday acknowledged just how good this NC State team is when he told his players, this will be a big-time game. If you don't bring your big-time stuff, we will not win.
Well, Shannon, 40 minutes from now, we'll have our answer. This has been the Infinity Tip-Off. Now let's take a look at how tonight's coaches have fun with fundraising in the Infinity Coaches Charity Challenge.
You've been training?
A little. How about you?
A little.
All right, the only way we raise the money is if we finish the race.
That's why I'm getting these quads breathing.
Those are your hams.
What do you mean? I'm supposed to pin this in? You don't have any glue?
You ready to do this?
I'm ready.
What kind of time are you looking for?
Probably 3, 3.5 for me.
Ooh.
Let's go back.
Good idea.
I need some water.
I don't think they give water out this early.
NCAA coaches, great at coaching, not so great at fundraising.
Go to ESPN.com/Infinity and vote for your favorite coach's charity in the Infinity Coaches Charity Challenge.
Welcome to Saturday Prime Time, presented by DirecTV. You're watching the ACC on ESPN. A full house here in Raleigh. The Tar Heels and the Wolfpack getting ready to go as we check out our one-on-one, Dick, two extremely talented forwards.
Well, I think right now, when you look at North Carolina, they're going to need a big game out of James Michael McAdoo. He's going to have to score around the basket and maybe get a guy like Howell in foul trouble. He can be effective inside. He's very athletic. He can run the court. And then there's C.J. Leslie. I mean, Dan, you and I saw him. He was superb against Duke. He had 25 played brilliantly. He has to bring his A game tonight. He needs that A game against McAdoo.
Here we go, Dick. State has not defeated Carolina in 13 consecutive games. That goes way back before any of these players were in the program. So none of the guys in red have beaten the guys in blue at the collegiate level.
You know, what's the big deal with Strickland's comments? The bottom line is he told the truth. Tell the truth. I mean, we're not worried about them. They have to prove us they can beat us.
You see the officiating crew, Mike Eads, Mike Stewart, Raymond Steins, the first possession of the night to the Wolfpack. Their outstanding point guard, Lorenzo Brown, is the ACC leader in assists. This is C.J. Leslie, big-time scorer. Had two big games, although they were in losses, against Carolina last year at a 24-point game, a 22-point game.
had 25 against Duke in the win 2 weeks ago. And Mark Gottfried says he loves the way his team has been practicing. He believes they're ready for this game. They need to take the energy and intensity they've been displaying in practice and take it into the game.
Well, you know, Dan, and the reason that teams like Duke and teams like North Carolina, off the glass, he called that one, have been so effective, they don't get to that point where they're so high. I mean, take a look at NC State. They beat Duke and North Carolina. Every time they've beaten them, they're 1-13 in 20 years after playing those teams and beating them. You got to be consistent.
McAdoo defended by Leslie. This is Bullock, 46% from beyond the arc, and freshman Rodney Purvis draws the assignment on him.
Well, I think the North Carolina win. Bullock's got to make shots, and Hairston, he's a really outstanding perimeter shooter.
Carolina is improving. They've won three in a row, including maybe the biggest game of their season, that road win in Florida State. McAdoo a miss, and Richard Howell down to the first of what's sure to be many rebounds.
Well, real good defensive effort by NC State in that possession. Played solid 5-on-5, and that's what they want to do. They want to neutralize and negate the transition game of North Carolina.
Both coaches telling a similar story. Both teams are good in transition. Leslie No, Carolina ball. Strickland off the fingertips of Desmond Huber.
Not a good pass. Going to drop the ball on a dime board.
Purvis, no. And McAdoo down to the board. The foul, by the way, that sent Leslie to the line was on McAdoo. They can ill afford to lose him.
Lorenzo Brown is really sensational in transition at the point guard slot. If they can rebound and get it to him, that's coming off the ball. You got to convert that.
Bullock could not, and back comes State.
Good movement without the ball.
NC State breaking out some special red uniforms here for this game here tonight. Just about everybody in the building wearing red, with the exception of a few brave souls in Carolina blue sprinkled here and there. Leslie, and is it McAdoo again, or is it Hubert? It's McAdoo with his second, less than 2 minutes into the game.
And that is really big, because they're limited on the bench in terms of the help on a front court. He's going to take him one-on-one. They get him for a foul. He says, hey, my arm's extended.
And the signal given by Mike Eats, the official, was that McAdoo lowered his arms, and you can see his right arm did go down. And now tension mounting already, as we mentioned. Two programs that don't like each other at all, and the officials already getting in the middle of a number of players to break it up and try to get everybody to talk less and play more.
I wish we had a camera on you and the way you were demonstrating with your arms.
I'm into it tonight.
You're into it. I see those arms flailing. Oh, wow. Free throw shooting has not been good for both North Carolina State and North Carolina.
Now Roy Williams is going to make a sub. I think Roy believed the foul was on somebody else, because just now Bryce Johnson got up and checked into the game. And James Michael McAdoo is going to sit down for a while.
He can't believe it. You're right. He thought that was possibly on Huber.
Yep. Out of bounds to the pack.
See, they're going to take advantage of that. If I'm NC State now, I'm pounding the ball to the interior. I'm getting it to Leslie and to Howell down inside. Attack them around the basket.
Boy, what an ominous beginning for North Carolina, with arguably their best player out with two fouls 2 minutes into the game.
And they're limited. Remember, this team lost four NBA first rounders.
Wood a miss. He is one of the nation's great shooters.
He didn't miss today in practice there. He made about 11 in a row for that same spot. I said, hey, Scott, that's like a layup to you.
Well, he's an Indiana kid. Marion, Indiana, grew up taking a lot of jump shots. Page, who rolled his right ankle in practice yesterday, looks okay. Misses the shot. Howell down with another rebound.
He's been playing better, Page, in terms of distributing the ball.
What a look. And then Purvis turns it over, but what a find by Lorenzo Brown.
You know, Mike Krzyzewski told me, he said he's as good as you'll find in transition with the ball in his hands as a point guard.
Well, the game we did 2 weeks ago when they beat Mike Krzyzewski's Blue Devils, Brown had 13 assists in that game.
He really operated with great poise in that game.
Looking inside, Howell. And it is out of bounds, still NC State ball, but they are pounding the ball inside, Dick, like you said.
Powell should have right there had a layup on the left side of the basket. He tried to go a little too far. He should have squared his body, brought his body back into the court. You young kids out there, when you make that baseline drive, you want to square your shoulders to the glass.
Now, Richard Howell is a senior, 6'8", 257. Bryce Johnson, who's guarding him, is a freshman, 6'9", 187. Dick, there's a 70-pound difference between the two of them. Brown from the corner.
That's good. They're a different team on this floor. The confidence, the intensity. To be really a good team, you have to take the same level of play on the road. Yep.
Recent road losses at Maryland and at Wake Forest. Missed shot by Strickland. Brown ahead to Purvis. And saved nicely by Bullock.
His page right now in transition, last 2 games, he's had 6 assists.
Pull-up 18-footer, left it short, and Johnson there with the rebound. Again, offensive rebounding, one of the best things Carolina has going for them.
Third in the nation. That really shocked me. Third in the nation. We're teasing Roy. We get a lot of opportunities, missing a lot of shots.
We'd like to see them shoot a little bit better. We'd like to see them get inside, get to the line more. Floats it up and in, Richard Howell.
Every time we see him, he looks so impressive. You and I had him against Connecticut. He was a difference maker. We had him against Duke, but he had 17 and 18.
16 and 18, yeah. Yeah. We're big fans, but he continues to be one of the more underrated big men in the country.
We saw an underrated big man the other day, Kaji, down there in Miami.
Turnaround by Johnson, and one thing the freshmen can do is score. They've got three freshman centers, Joel James, is a big guy. Johnson is the guy who can score, and Hubert's the best defender. Roy Williams says, if you could combine the three of them, you'd have a heck of a player. Scott Wood doing what he does best.
And that's what he's doing before the game, young kids. Working on his shot. I'm telling you, he made like 11 in a row when I was watching.
Bullock with the answer for the Tar Heels.
And he has to be their answer. He's been playing really well recently.
Purvis a miss. Guess who with the rebound? It's Howell again.
Big advantage. Big advantage of McAdoo on that sideline. Goes to NC State with Wesley and Howell on the glass.
Carolina with no answer on the inside thus far for Richard Howell.
You know, Bullock had a big game against Maryland. 21 at halftime.
Bullock off balance. Leslie snags the rebound.
I look at their personnel. I really feel they have a chance to be dominant. They really do. Yeah.
Brown with a floater.
They're a very impressive team. Maybe when you and I see them, they play at a different level.
Not very deep. Really six players doing almost all the damage, getting almost all the minutes for the Wolfpack. Strickland, no. Johnson, the rebound. Puts it back up. No.
So here's where they really want to get out in transition.
Brown. Howell with another rebound and yet another. He's got 5 boards already. Look at him go. Rejected by Johnson.
He goes after every rebound like it's his last meal, man. He goes laterally.
What a start for the Wolfpack.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by DirecTV. Don't just watch TV, DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. And in part by Infiniti, luxury cars that deliver inspired performance. And Wendy's. Now that's better.
Welcome back to PNC Arena. It was just 2 weeks ago when this place went crazy. NC State beating crosstown rivals Duke right here on this court. The fans in the crowd, they stormed the court, and things got very scary for a moment. Will Prevett, who's in a wheelchair, he was born without a right tibia, was in the middle of everything. He got knocked over. DJ Leslie picked Will up, and Will, as well as all of the fans, are back here today. Will also rocking a brand new t-shirt. President, I asked asked Will if he would do it again, if he would get back out there and do it again, Dan, and he said absolutely. They also told me they're not planning on storming the court if they are able to win tonight.
Tell you what, he changed his opinion. He told me earlier today, Shannon, he said, no, I'm never going to rush to court again. Yeah, by the way, Shannon, let me tell you this. His father and his grandfather went to North Carolina. I said, why didn't you go? He said, well, I don't want to talk about it. I think I know why.
Lorenzo Brown with a three, and then P.J. Hairston answers at the other end for Carolina. 18-10, Joel James, number zero, into the game for the first time for Carolina. And T.J. Warren, outstanding freshman, number 24 for State, has checked in for the first time.
Yeah, he's had some great games scoring.
A little strong. James down with a rebound. James, an experience. He's really only been playing competitive basketball for 3 years, but he's got the body to play inside.
He really does have a body. You can't teach that. Physical, the listening staff, coaching staff, Roy Williams, Steve Robinson, Hubert Davis, our buddy. He works with them. He can be a player.
James Michael McAdoo, if you're just joining in, two fouls less than 2 minutes into the game. And NC State's been playing with energy. They're dominating on the glass, knocking down some threes.
Well, they got experience, too. We saw that in Miami. Nothing like having good players who are experienced players. Look at Brown and Wood.
Wood fumbled the pass, so he couldn't get the shot off.
You got to find him. You can't let him shoot, catch and shoot.
J.P. Tokido is on him. Nice shot fake. Leslie, and a foul is called on Joel James, who thought he had a clean block. He's got a look of disbelief on his face.
Well, I do, too. I thought he made a good defensive play. Here's Leslie going in. He's rotating. Wow, he made contact with the shoulder. Made contact.
So Leslie at the line. Generally known as CJ, Mark Gottfried calls him Calvin, his given name. Of course, they had CJ Williams last year, but Coach Gottfried saying, you know what, turn the page, fresh start. Talked last year about, you know, is he engaged, is he mature enough, saying, hey, turn over a new leaf. This is a new Leslie. So in practice, you hear Mark Gottfried hollering out Calvin instead of CJ.
I'll tell you, Calvin's multi-skilled. He really is. Got a lot of skills. He'll go inside, outside, very versatile play. Has good man-to-man defense.
Strickland at the point right now. Page on the bench.
Making him play their five-man half-court game. And that's what Mark Gottfried told us. He said, we want to take away the transition game. We want to play us five-on-five.
Time to shoot. Strickland going to have to force something.
What a great job defensively. That was a commitment defensively by all five players. They were unified. They were unified. Play defense as a unit. Yeah, pitcher chest. You deserve it.
Roy Williams said he was curious to see how his young team would respond in a hostile environment like this. And they have not done all that well. They lost at Virginia. They did pick up the big win at Florida State. Remember, we saw them earlier in the year at Indiana. At Texas, they lost as well. This is a challenge for a young team to come into this kind of an environment.
You know, Florida State really isn't a hostile environment. We saw them in Bloomington, yep. And they were rallying in Paris that game.
T.J. Warren, who is shooting 65% from the field.
He's a scorer. Daddy played here. Having a tough time getting the shots they want out of their offensive sets.
Carolina ball when we come back, but it's been all Wolfpack so far. I'd like to see you doing a little big air, a little super tight.
I think I'd be pretty good at that. Are you serious?
I have a slightly different opinion.
I think your opinion's right.
NC State up big in the early going. David Raleigh leading 22-10. North Carolina's won 13 in a row over NC State, 19 of the last 20. But the Wolfpack have taken advantage of early foul trouble by James Michael McAdoo. It's going to be fascinating to see if Roy Williams brings him back in at any point this half. He had to take him out of the game less than 2 minutes in.
They want to have a great performance as well in the world of recruiting. They're one of the top players in the United States here, Julius Randle.
Yes.
I met Julius to the pitcher.
Yeah, ranked fourth on the ESPN 100. Paul Biancardi speaking very highly of him earlier today. Hairston with an air ball, so he's going to hear that the rest of the night.
North Carolina struggling in their offensive efficiency. Can't get the kind of shots they want. Great effort and a commitment defensively right now by North Carolina State.
Jordan Vandenberg into the game for NC State, 7-1 redshirt junior out of Australia, giving Richard Howell a breather.
Got to get some minutes on those guys because Leslie and Howell play like 35 every night.
Leslie, one-on-one with Johnson. Can't get the shot off and didn't get out of the key in time. So 3 seconds on NC State, and McAdoo's coming back into the game.
Don't want to pick up that dribble. That's a no-no. A lot of young kids have that problem, picking up their dribble.
But now McAdoo, I mean, I'm sure he's glad to be back in the game, but he's got to be awfully careful. If he picks up his third, he's gone for the half.
You know, they got to play him. They got to play him.
Well, they lost him on this end, and he's right back into it with a slam.
You got to play your star now. You can't afford to go down by 20 at halftime. Can't worry about that foul. You got to play him.
And he is still on C.J. Leslie, a tough matchup.
And I would go right at him. See, if I get Leslie now, I play a little two-man game. Brown and Leslie against McAdoo. You got to understand situations and strategy.
Here's Leslie.
You can take him one-on-one. Not a good pass. You got to post him on a box. First of all, you got good size.
Now Leslie out, and Howell comes in. So McAdoo looking to the bench saying, who do you want me to take, coach? Do I take Vandenberg or do I take Howell?
I put him on Vandenberg. I don't think he's a threat offensively.
He's on Howell right now. Shot clock at 2. And a foul against NC State.
See, I don't think they utilize real good strategy in that possession. I mean, you got to know right now their star's got 2 fouls. Mm-hmm. So he's going to be a little tentative. He's going to be hesitant.
Page, the freshman, having to battle Lorenzo Brown, one of the country's great point guards.
And that Page struggling shooting the ball. He's passed it fairly well, but he's 2-for-13 coming into this game.
And misses that 3. Tokido runs down the offensive rebound.
Yeah, the last 2 games.
Hairston, the pull-up. Got it.
Now he can make shots. He can make shots.
Brown looking to post, gets it off, a little bit strong. Still loose, and Wolfpack ball.
Now Brown has great size for a perimeter player. A lot of people at the next level like his game, can handle it. He was originally here a second guard.
Warren, no.
The point guard was Ryan Harrell, who transferred
right
over to Kentucky.
McAdoo with a full head of steam.
Uh-oh.
And it's going to be a block on Richard Howell.
Should be a block.
Big Monday with a primetime doubleheader right here on ESPN at 7 Eastern. It'll be Pittsburgh against Louisville. The Cardinals have lost 3 in a row. Lost at Georgetown earlier today. And then Kansas at West Virginia at 9 Eastern. A big Monday presented by Bud Light. Another win for Kansas today as they beat Oklahoma. They're going to move up the rankings, though the top 10 is going to look completely different next week than it did this week with all of the losses sustained by top 10 teams.
I'm going to tell you a danger zone for Kansas going to be when I have to make that journey to Iowa State. When they make that journey up there, I've never been there for a game. People tell me it is absolutely bananas up there. Had a good win today over Kansas State.
Very good win. Kansas State, another ranked team. 5 ranked teams lost on the road today. Syracuse, Louisville, Kansas State, Minnesota, and New Mexico.
See, you made a very interesting point. On the road, common denominator, all lost away from home. Talked about that on game day, the emotion, the passion.
Jackson Simmons into the game now for Carolina, number 21, defending Howell. McAdoo is still in the game. Page through the hands of Simmons. Tough pass, really. And now the officials will overrule and give it to NC State, which is the correct call.
You know, a tough situation for Marcus Page. Has to come in and replace a guy as a first-round draft choice, Kendall Marshall. I firmly believe, and I don't take anything away from Kentucky, but right there battling at the end, if Henson doesn't get hurt and Marshall doesn't get hurt, North Carolina really had all the pieces.
Wood deep in the corner, can't get the shot off. If you're covering Scott Wood, you're going to get your running in because he's going to be zipping around a series of screens all night long. Here he comes again. Gets it off. And the rebound down to Page. You know, all things considered, Dick, considering the feel of the game and the McAdoo foul trouble, Carolina's only down 6.
Exactly. North Carolina State the last 3-4 minutes has not been effective with the basketball. Page should be able to get them in their offensive sets. He was a big-time scorer on the high school level. Oh.
Dribbled it off his foot. And that's going to be another turnover.
Great family. Dad is a juvenile probation officer. Mom's an English teacher. Sister plays for Wisconsin.
What a scene tonight at PNC Arena in Raleigh. NC State up six on their rivals from Chapel Hill. All right.
What about your favorite American?
Thank you very much.
What about your favorite American?
You're my favorite American. Hey, next week when we go to Bloomington, you all right if we talk a little Stauskas, talk a little Canada? You good with that?
Absolutely.
All right. Michigan at Indiana, 1 week from tonight. Are we looking forward to that? If Michigan can win tomorrow, they're likely going to go into next week as the top-ranked team in the nation.
That's not going to be easy, though, play like Illinois. If Illinois is a very dangerous team, even though they haven't played well. A little walk right there. You mentioned next week, Mr. Batista's going to be there for
that's
the Toronto
right.
Blue Jays.
There's going to be all kinds of people at the game. This is for Coaches versus Cancer, the Suits and Sneakers weekend, as coaches try to raise awareness for cancer research. So Mark Gottfried and the NC State staff are all wearing red sneakers. McAdoo with the turnaround. Simmons with the follow. Roy Williams is wearing purple sneakers to try to raise awareness towards research and pancreatic cancer. He's got a buddy of his who is here tonight who is suffering from pancreatic cancer, so Roy wearing purple in honor of his friend.
Good offensive rebound by Simmons there.
Howell, no, but he gets it back. And which way is it going to go? It will be an offensive foul on Leslie.
The whole Carolina bench up with that call. Mark Godfrey not happy with it. They got themselves right back in this game, North Carolina. Digging in. There's the contact. I think it's a good call. I thought it was a good call.
It was 22-10. McAdoo was on the bench with fouls, and it looked like the Wolfpack might blow the heels right out of the building. 8-0 run Carolina since.
They haven't been able to score NC State.
A miss by Bullock, rebound to Leslie. NC State has to score in more than 5 minutes. A good look here for Purvis.
He had three big threes in their last game.
He's a freshman, a McDonald's All-American, averaging 9.9 points per game. They've got five in double figures, and then Purvis just shy of being the sixth.
That shows you great balance. Yep. 9.9. He's averaging 10 in my books. You round that off. I learned that with a 9.5.
Nice look.
Oh, yes. That's a big five, John. Roy Williams not happy with the defensive positioning there. That's a big five, John, on the inside. And that's a good job. Raleigh, baby. Before the season, everyone said, forget Carolina, forget Duke. The best of the best. Is North Carolina State, but they're going to prove it, man. They're going to prove it for the entire year. You can't just do it in special games. And that's why I've always had great admiration and respect for teams like Kansas and Duke and North Carolina. They really respond game after game.
A quick six-point spurt by the Wolfpack. All of a sudden, the lead is 10. As Roy Williams makes a couple of subs, Johnson and Tocado back into the game, and this place is alive again.
Tocado gives him an explosive athlete.
6'5 wing guy, good offensive rebounder. Looking for Simmons. Page misses the three.
He's got to make some shots. He's getting wide open looks.
Brown behind the back. Behind the back again. And Johnson on the alley-oop from Tocado to temporarily quiet the crowd.
Two diaper Randy's hook up with the diagonal pass. See, Brandon transition. That's when he's at his best. And he can go up and down the floor with the ball.
Pulls up inside the lane, in and out, Johnson the rebound.
Johnson's given him positive minutes.
Yes, he is.
He really has been very productive off that bench.
And again, look at him. Look at the difference in his ball compared to guys like Leslie and especially Howell, but he's given all he's got.
He's got to get in that weight room and really build that body.
He can score. Misses the jump hook. Leslie down with the rebound. Brown spinning, hitting.
He's terrific in transition. He is absolutely a one-man fast break. Last two possessions, Brown really showing why he's one of the premier point guards, not only the ACC, but the country. And there are a lot of good ones out there. I think the best is Trey Burke. I love Trey Burke.
Johnson off the back of the iron. Rebound Leslie. Number five on the glass for him. Brown again. Wood. Leslie, the offensive rebound.
I thought he got fouled,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he did. You're
he got
right.
fouled. And yep. He should have grabbed and hit his arm.
Hey, I'll tell you this. Had anybody blown a whistle, we wouldn't have heard it. It is deafening in here. Howell got it.
Richard Howell attacked to the rim. See, right now, North Carolina not getting any point production out of the point guard slot. And they got to get some. That was one of the problems today, Louisville. Payne Seaman didn't have a point. Only played 23 minutes. He's in foul trouble.
Largest lead of the night. Johnson can't finish. Missed again. And Brown is fouled.
Last 3 minutes, it's been all North Carolina State. It's been all North Carolina State.
And Dickie, it's been all Lorenzo Brown.
Yeah, Lorenzo Brown, you know, love. Look at that wraparound pass, conversion. Next time he said, what about the spin move, baby? Look at the spin move. I'm going to kiss it right off the glass.
ESPN's journey to the tourney continues next week. Trey Burke, Cody Zeller, Tim Hardaway Jr., Victor Oladipo, Michigan, Indiana, Assembly Hall, Bloomington, the Wolverines, and the Hoosiers, both top 10 teams. These rankings could both go up if they can both win tomorrow. It is going to be an unbelievable night. Reese and Digger and Jay and Jalen will be with us in Bloomington next week to see two of the best players, two of the best teams in the country.
It should really be exciting down here. I'll tell you one thing. When you look at that matchup, you got to talk about certainly the inside play. Zeller did not have a great game the other day. I couldn't believe the numbers. Had like 2 points against Penn State. He'll have to be at his A game against that Michigan front line.
You know, people forget how young Michigan is. They've got 5 freshmen getting significant minutes for them, and they'll be in a very hostile environment against Indiana. It's going to be an absolute barn burner for sure. The Wolverines and the Hoosiers 1 week from tonight here on ESPN. Page forces it up.
He's really struggling. He's 0-for-5 right now.
Carlos with the finish.
And in transition, that has been the difference. Page is 0-for-5. He's 1 assist, 2 turnovers. On the other end, you look at their point guard, Lorenzo Brown, 4-for-8. He's got 10 points, no turnovers.
14 points in transition tonight for NC State. They average 22 a game. The second highest in the nation. Here they go again, looking to add to the totals, and they will.
What a pass, 1-81. Transition up and down the floor. Oh, Jimmy B would love this style of play. When they get a transition, I find it hard to believe they lose to Wake Forest and Maryland. I really don't. Look at this personnel. Remember, they've lost 13 in a row to North Carolina.
Sure, we've been anywhere louder than this building is tonight. NC State on a 20-2 run. Up 22 on the Tar Heels.
He sat through something like this layup after layup in that game of Miami and Duke. And look what Duke did today. I tell you, that was not a surprise to me. Coach K, after that loss, they came back and beat Maryland by 20 today.
Tocado knocks down the jumper. Rasheed Suleiman with 25 to lead the Blue Devils.
Oh, he should turn it right to the basket.
And he's fouled. Leslie heading back to the free throw line again.
All he had to do was drop step and go to the baseline. He had a jam.
Coming up on the UPS Halftime Report, a look at a very busy day in college basketball, including, as Dick mentioned, Duke returning to form with a win over Maryland. And as we discussed a little bit earlier, five ranked teams lost on the road against unranked teams today. Just kind of symptomatic of what we've seen all season long in college basketball. It's so unpredictable.
Well, you and I talked about it the other day in the Miami game. We talked about how it's wide open. How really right now, when you look at March Madness, that is going to be one unbelievable scene. And I'm talking good teams. There are a lot of good basketball teams.
I'll tell you a game to look forward to with the ACC, Miami and North Carolina State. Leslie with a rejection. Loose ball to Wood, running again.
Oh, look at his running layups, baby. Layups. Layups. This is so similar. Deja vu of what we saw the other day.
No answers right now for Carolina. James. Wild shot.
Not able to do what their coach set out to do. He said we must control their transition game.
Boy, look at the sharing of the basketball, two by State. Leslie in and out. Howell called for the foul. That'll be his second. Transition has been a huge key tonight, Dick, for State.
Well, that's their strength. When they're able to run up and down the floor, you better make that play five on five because they have too many athletes. They can go up and down the floor. Lorenzo Brown's been sensational. He's been a PTP'er tonight, baby.
Richard Howell sits down as well. By the way, that Miami-NC State game is in this building 1 week from today, next Saturday afternoon, and that's the only regular season meeting. State does not go down to Miami during the regular season.
Tell you another game look forward to in the ACC. Miami on a journey to Cameron Indoor Stadium.
That's later on in the season on March the 2nd, a Saturday, as Duke will be looking for a little bit of revenge.
Look at NC State right now. You talk about some of their key wins. They have a win over Connecticut, a win over Duke, and a win over Stanford. They have not beaten Duke and North Carolina in the same year since 2003. They got a great chance for it to happen this year.
Same regular season, I believe. Yeah, that hasn't happened in 10 years. They've already beaten Duke here this year. Did that a couple of weeks ago as Brown checks back in. Vandenberg to the bench.
They're 11-0 at home. They're a different team on this floor. And I think before you can put them as an elite team, they have to play well away from here. They'll beat by Oklahoma State by 20.
That's the one game that really irks Mark Gottfried. He said the loss to Wake Forest doesn't even bother him as much. They have three guys in foul trouble. They were playing defense kind of cautiously. The Oklahoma State game's the only one where they were really not in it. One of their four losses on the season.
And a young freshman there, Devin Thomas, had a monster game.
25.
25 points. Had a tough game with Clemson. They couldn't handle inside. Devin Booker, he had 27. In fact, Lorenzo Brown, I read a quote, said, he's the strongest dude I ever saw. So I thought maybe Howell was. He said, this guy is so strong, it's unreal.
Well, one thing that they can all agree on is that Lorenzo Brown is one of the premier point guards in America, and he has shown that tonight.
Well, a lot of great point guards, but here he is right there with a great pass. He's got people that can finish off the block. There he is, good vision, has great size to point. You got guys out there.
Officially credited with four assists. We just saw four of them right there. Feels like he's got more than four, but he's been controlling the game for most of the night.
Well, he's not turning the ball over either, and he's really creating tempo. He's creating the pace of the game. Point guard is so vital to you. If you don't get great point guard play, and today, obviously, Louisville didn't get great point guard play, you're going to suffer. You have to be strong at that point slot.
McAdoo back on the bench has played sparingly because of the two fouls tonight.
You know, I thought McAdoo early in the year, expectations, all of us, we saw him in a 15-minute stint last year with Henson and Zella. And you don't see a kid's real liabilities and some of the things that maybe they got to work on. And everybody was talking, you know, All-American, first team, second team. Yeah. He's a good, solid player, but he's a long way from that.
And of course, even when he was in there, when Henson was hurt, he had Zeller with him, he had Barnes with him, he had Marshall with him, he had people taking some of the pressure off him. He came into this season as the man.
He's a very good college player. There's no doubt about it. 14-8 on the Saturday night, you can count on. But not when you're talking about top five in the country.
Shot clock turned off.
What a performance. What a performance defensively and the running game by North Carolina State.
Strickland pushed off a little to get free and then knocks down the jumper. Time for State. Brown loses it. And the first half comes to a close with North Carolina State led by Lorenzo Brown and their outstanding transition game. Look at that. 20-0 on the break. And a 19-point lead at halftime for the Wolfpack over the Tar Heels. Shannon Spake is with Mark Godfrey.
Coach, this has been a big momentum game. What's been the difference when the momentum has been on your side?
Our defense. We've been guarding them. We got to stay down in the stance and make them make tough, hard shots. We've been quick. We're talking better tonight than we did in our last game defensively. I think that's going to be the key for us.
A lot of emotion. We've seen it out of your players, but there's 20 more minutes to play. What do you say to them to keep them focused?
We were here the other day. We were up 12 on the road and didn't get it done, so we got to learn from our lessons, and we got to play another 20 minutes hard.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, Shannon, thank you. They played a good, hard first 20 minutes, up 19, getting it done at both ends of the floor so far. When we come back, Reese, Digger, Jay deliver the UPS halftime reports.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by the Capital One Cup, recognizing the best in college sports. Check the standings at CapitalOneCup.com.
It's been 13 games of frustration. North Carolina State, a cathartic first half. Still 20 minutes to go, but it's a 45-26 edge for the Wolfpack over the Tar Heels. They've dropped 13 straight to their in-state rival. You saw Lorenzo Brown, the guard for NC State. He was fantastic in the first half. Reese Davis, Digger Phelps, and Jay Billis. And Jay, as you anticipated, transition game's really the difference in this game. A conversion game, as you call it.
It's amazing how quickly NC State not only gets down the floor, but when they get a rebound, their outlets are fabulous. Their big guys get the ball out so quickly, and their first three steps, their rush up the court is really hard to deal with. If you don't stop Lorenzo Brown in transition, forget it. He's going to get a shot, or he's going to find somebody else. It was devastating, their transition game. In North Carolina, their entire offense was in the half court. They only shot 30%. The only thing they got in transition, they got one secondary break dunk off that wing back screen. I think it was Bryce Johnson got a dunk. That was it. Everything else was half court, and they only had 30% in the first half. You're not going to win doing that.
McAdoo getting two quick fouls, going to the bench with, 18 minutes and a half. That allowed NC State to get that transition game, especially with Lorenzo Brown. They just went up and down. They knew how to get it done. They got it to four, Carolina, but then it was that big run when they just blew this thing out. But understand this. When you get 20 fast break points, that means you're not scoring, and the other team's running against you. Carolina really struggled getting back in transition defense. And when you look at the stats, Bullock and McAdoo end up going 2-for-8 in the first half. If they're not scoring, Carolina's not getting in the game.
Put that 20 points in transition or fast break points that Digger was talking about in perspective. North Carolina State's among the best in the nation. 22 per game is what they average. They got 22 for 20 in the first half, just two off of their season game average. Earlier today, just down the road at Duke, Maryland taking on the currently number one ranked team in the land. Rashid Suleiman had a terrific day. Shot it well from the perimeter, took it to the bucket there. He had 25. Duke goes up by 19. Now, Jay, what about this follow from Plumlee?
Mason Plumlee is a spectacular athlete. I mean, how do you analyze that? How do you even do that? I can't do that on a Nerf hoop.
He got a T for taunting or slapping the ball away or something at the end. Didn't matter. Duke won by 20 over Maryland. Great finish. Syracuse and Villanova. This was at the end of regulation. James Bell missed it. Moved Yeru, the great kick out to Ryan Archidiakono for the three. Tied at 61, and Bell, who missed one in regulation, didn't miss him in overtime.
He hit two big threes in overtime to put him in that big lead.
75-71. Villanova gets the victory. They beat Louisville and Syracuse in consecutive games, 75-71. Louisville and Georgetown tied at 50. This one came right down to the end. And we saw what Mason Plumlee did. Aaron Bowie, this is a pretty good follow. No, this is Louisville-Georgetown. There's a follow. How about Aaron Bowen's follow, 52-50, and then Peyton Sebu didn't score.
Bad shot.
Couldn't get it to go, and Georgetown gets the win. Hoyas playing better. They beat Notre Dame, then beat Louisville today, so they've got a couple wins in a row. We've got Kansas coming up. Kansas challenged for a while by Oklahoma. We'll show you how the big fellas and a little help from Relifer took care of business.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. Let UPS put the power of logistics to work for you. Welcome back to the UPS Halftime Report.
Brittany Griner came into her game against Oklahoma for Baylor this afternoon, needing six blocks to set the NCAA all-time record. She got eight swats against the Sooners, 665 blocks for her glorious career. That is the most in NCAA history for the reigning national champion, as Baylor won easily over Oklahoma. The Oklahoma men at the Fog to take on Bill Self in Kansas. You're going to see Ben McLemore knock down a three. Jay, what would you say if I tried to make a case for Kansas to be number one next week?
I think Kansas makes a great case for number one. They've only lost once, that being to Michigan State. This is a really good basketball team.
67-54, Withy on the finish. Kansas continues its role. You'll be able to see the Jayhawks against a struggling West Virginia team on Big Monday that will be preceded by Pittsburgh and Louisville. Louisville, who's now lost three in a row after falling to Georgetown. In fact, five ranked teams went on the road and lost on Saturday against unranked teams, including Kansas State. Kansas State, of course, they just lost to Kansas. They went to Ames, got beat by Iowa State. Minnesota's now lost four in a row. And what had happened with New Mexico is that they didn't score any points. They got drilled by San Diego State. Good team for sure, just unranked, 55-34 score. All right, what's the biggest adjustment? This thing's a blowout right now. It's 45-26 NC State. Can North Carolina get back in it?
NC State's got to keep it going. Remember, they're up 16 the first half the other night at Wake Forest, and Wake Forest got Bennett. First 4 minutes, Jay, NC State's going to go at it. If Carolina has any shot, they got to try to get it to 10 and then go under 10 to get momentum. That's doubtful.
Yeah, for both teams, it starts with their defense. You got to get stops. And North Carolina did not make NC State inbound the ball in the first half. I mean, the inbounds were 2-1. It was North Carolina inbounding the ball. They have got to make him take it out of the net and run some better offense to get that running game stopped.
Lorenzo Brown leads the ACC in assists in conference plays, getting 8 a night. They only had 4 in the first half, but man, it seemed like he had a bunch more. How about the push down to Rodney Purvis and the flush? Godfrey's team up big.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. Let UPS put the power of logistics to work for you.
There's a stretch of asphalt in North Carolina called Tobacco Road. Yeah, you may have heard of it. Yeah, you may see a Tar Heel or a Cameron Crazy along the way. But don't forget who's at the other corner of the triangle. Beyond the hills, the Wolfpack play a little basketball, too. Like when David Thompson and company leapt over the field into the Final Four and to the title. Or when a last-second miracle sent Jimmy B in search of somebody to hug.
The team has done it. The Wolfpack has won the national championship.
Yeah, buddy. Tobacco Road's a tough place for a program not named North Carolina or Duke. But NC State has enjoyed its own moments of glory, with many more to come.
You're watching the ACC on ESPN. And the preseason ACC favorite, not North Carolina, not Duke, North Carolina State. And they're trying to make a statement. Yeah, they've slipped up a couple of times. They lost at Wake. They lost at Maryland. They beat Duke here. And as you said, they're a different team in this building. And they are looking outstanding here tonight.
Well, 11-0. They're shooting the ball really well, defending well. You look at North Carolina, 10-33. That's not going to get it done, shooting the basketball on the road at that level. And then you have the transition game. They've been absolutely scintillating in transition.
Outscoring Carolina 20-0 in transition tonight. James Michael McAdoo played only 8 minutes in the first half because of foul trouble. Bullock the miss. Richard Howe, 8 points and 8 rebounds. Lorenzo Brown, 12 points and 4 assists. Per Purvis misses the three. C.J. Leslie, 9 points, 7 rebounds. Big numbers in the first half for State. Strickland misses the baseline layup.
Tell you one thing, the first 5 minutes of this half, really a big, big time for North Carolina.
And Purvis is down. And we can't see him from where we are because he's on our side of the court, just down the court. It may have been ever since the three-pointer that he took at the end of the last North Carolina State possession. We'll try to get another look.
He's a young diaper dandy, very capable on a perimeter, very explosive.
And they're looking at the left foot and ankle. The last possession for NC State ended on a missed three, and there it is right there. Turn the left ankle as he landed on the foot of Dexter Strickland. How often do you see that? Purvis is back up and is going to make his way to the bench as T.J. Warren checks in again. This is one of the, if you have a concern about North Carolina State, this is one of them. They're really only 60. Vandenberg plays a little bit. Tyler Lewis, a backup point guard, plays a little bit. But the top six do about 95% of the scoring.
Yeah, they lack depth. And really, that's not going to be much of a problem in the tournament time. When you talk about long term, it becomes a problem.
Just talking about the possibility of an injury if they get down to five for any reason. It's a whole different story.
Right now, big time for North Carolina. They got to put a little spurt on.
Page inside, misses the reverse.
He's really trying so hard. You feel the kid pressing. He's a great kid. And he just can't get a shot to go down.
Carolina will retain possession. Page is 0 for 6 from the field tonight. Crowd just got a look at a replay. They didn't like it the second time around either. Bullock is a guy, if they're going to get back in this game, you figure he's the guy who's going to have to do it.
Well, Bullock or Harris, they're going to have to go on fire and knock him out some threes.
Kicked out of bounds, and the shot clock will reset to 15 as they work on the left ankle of freshman Rodney Purvis, taping it up.
People down in North Carolina, they expect nothing but greatness year in and year out. But with the one-and-done rule, they've really been hurt as much as any team in America losing players early.
Strickland, no. And rebound to Howell. That's his 10th. That's his 8th consecutive double-figure rebounding game. In conference play, Dick, he's averaging over 13 rebounds a game.
Well, there's no doubt he's one of the premier rebounders, not only in the ACC, but nationwide. He can really flat out go after the basketball.
Doesn't get a lot of glory, but boy, does he do the dirty work. Knocked out of bounds, still Wolfpack ball.
You know, a lot of pride at stake right now. North Carolina got to reach down and play with some passion and heart and try to get back and scrap the claw to get in this game. 19-1, Roy Williams is against North Carolina State. 19 out of 20 times. I said it on game day. You can't have a rivalry, man, until you can win some games. Yeah,
and they've won 13 in a row.
That had no shot. That was Brick City. That looked like your jump shot. I saw your jump shot. That looked like your jump shot right there.
I'm not arguing with you. Page the pull-up. He's 0 for 7.
He's going to get people involved right now and give himself an easier shot, maybe in transition. Don't still play when he's struggling. Get out of transition.
Now trying to defend Lorenzo Brown at the other end. Pass tipped away by Page. Stolen by McAdoo.
He's out of bounds.
And out of bounds back to NC State as we check in with Shannon Spake.
Yeah, Dan, as those Carolina blue jerseys walk through the arena coming out of the locker room, the red painted walls, the look on their face was focused. I spoke with Roy Williams. He told me, brutally honest, we did not play in the first 20 minutes. I asked him what he thought of his players to prove that they'll come back and play the next 20. He said, I didn't see anything, but they'll play.
And like so many coaches, Shannon and Dick, in college basketball these days, as a block is called, McAdoo just picked up his third. Young teams playing on the road. A lot of teams don't play many road games before, true road games before conference play. And sometimes this is a real eye-opening experience in the month of January.
You know, I think the schools would be better off trying to play a couple of tough games early, get ready for the conference schedule. But everybody likes that home game, and if you can pack it and bring in a dash, why not?
Now, to be fair, Carolina did. They went to Maui. They played Butler there. They played Mississippi State there. They played at Texas. They played at Indiana. So they did have some tests before conference play.
Well, not successful at Texas. is really not really a good basketball team this year. I'll be the first to tell you.
McAdoo on the inside.
They're going to get more possessions inside the McAdoo. And some conversion down here in that low post.
Loose ball bounces to Warren, and he finishes.
Well, he just scores. The guy's got a nose to score. He gets games with 22. He's had a couple of Zippo games.
Page can't get one to go. Brown.
Nice look.
Russell.
Nice look right by. See, Page is on the other end, and the defensive transition, they didn't have enough people back. I think he's going to take Page out of the game.
Well, I think you're right. Luke Davis, a 6-foot sophomore from Raleigh, is going to come into the game for Carolina. And you would imagine it's going to be for Page, who's having a tough night. Davis on the season has played a total of 63 minutes in 11 games, and he's about to enter this game.
Cowboys going to the bench, bringing in also Johnson. You know, you have a roster like they had last year. I mean, it's unbelievable when you think about it. Four first round is Barron, Zella. You think about that club with Marshall,
Henson.
Unbelievable.
Davis into the game. He is a transfer from Gardner Webb. Sat out last year after transferring. McAdoo, and it's caught by Leslie, but that'll be goaltending.
I don't think there's any doubt. I mean, Stevie Wonder could have seen that one. Are you kidding me? That was so obvious. Oh, wow. I love Stevie Wonder.
Point lead, Wolfpack. Brown. And it's out of bounds. Still NC State ball as they went right after Davis trying to post Brown on the inside on him.
They got post-up ability. They got perimeter ability. They got good balance, offensive and defensive end.
Brown splits the defense, finds Warren. Wood, and it's out of bounds to take us to the under 16 media timeout. Mark Gottfried doesn't look all that happy right now, but his team's got a healthy lead.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Wendy's. Now that's better.
Tradition down here on Tobacco Road, and not just in Durham and Chapel Hill, but here in Raleigh as well. The 1983 national champions, of course, Jim Valvano, your good friend, the head coach, honored with his jersey up in the rafters here.
Well, you know, Jimmy V, he's made so much of an impact on so many people that are battling cancer. I want to send out right now a tribute to a friend. A guy by the name of Derek Thompson has been so good to me and our gala, donating a lot of money. A very young guy. And his young cousin, who he loves dearly, is right now, Brian Lindstrom, battling a fourth stage cancer and has a couple of young kids, and he's really in an incredible battle and has to sit down with his kids and tell them what he's facing. And it breaks your heart. We wish you the best, Brian. Wish you the best, man. Keep fighting. A lot of people love you. I know your cousin loves you. You got a beautiful wife. Kids, just keep battling and battling. I hate that disease, Dad. Cancer just flat out, so there's so many times just sucks. It's absolutely what it does to people. It breaks my heart.
Well, so amazing to see the work that you do with the V Foundation, what the coaches are doing tonight and all the time for Coaches Versus Cancer, and just raising as much money as we can. Another Carolina turnover.
Right now, North Carolina State's going to be back in their rhythm a little bit. There it is right there.
You said it. He's got a knack for putting the ball in the basket. T.J. Warren again.
Well, you're talking about shoot 65%.
Yep.
He's just got that unorthodox way, and he's just flat out a scorer.
Look at the defense scorer by Howell. And it's State ball.
They've been playing really committed defense here tonight.
NBA Sunday on ABC begins with a doubleheader tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock Eastern time. It'll be LeBron James into Miami taking on the struggling Boston Celtics. And then Kevin Durant in Oklahoma City in L.A. to take on Kobe and the Lakers. Coverage tips off with Kia NBA Countdown at 12:30.
Celtics really lost 6 in a row. I got a question for you. If the phone rings and you're Oklahoma City, would you trade Durant for James?
You can't trade either one of those guys, no matter who you are. You can't trade Durant for James, and you can't trade James for Durant.
I agree.
LeBron had a great quote about why he worked so hard. He said, because somebody's coming after me. Somebody wants to take what I have, and that somebody lives in Oklahoma.
Well, you know what I love about him, too? He's like a little kid. Did you see him yesterday?
Kevin Durant's
floor.
Talking about it? LeBron, yeah.
LeBron,
yeah.
And he hugged the guy and made the half-court shot.
That was great.
Yeah. I love LeBron. I mean, he's the best of the best.
Another turnover.
Here it goes. Four on two.
And Leslie coast to coast.
That's unbelievable. You see a big guy with his multi-skills. He should be a dominator on the collegiate level.
McAdoo on the assist from Tokido.
See, that's their strength. The running game has been totally negated here today. Yep. North Carolina's transition game has been shut down.
Leslie tipped in by Howell.
Howell gets the tip in, but that was another excellent move by Leslie.
12 points and 11 rebounds for Richard Howell. McAdoo misses the 15-footer. Leslie the board.
He should be like a man playing with boys, Leslie, in his league. He really should be.
Purvis back in after leaving with a twisted ankle. Misses the shot. And here's Davis.
I think he's his biggest enemy. I think that Leslie has a tendency not to focus. He's too talented. He can be as good as he wants to be. He can be one of the premier players in college on a consistent basis.
No question. He is averaging about 15 points and 7 rebounds per game. Played extremely well against Duke and having another big night tonight here against Carolina. Backdoor cut. Brown from Howell.
What a tremendous job of executing. Lorenzo Brown. A terrific assist. Talking about assists, I remember that Corciani to Monroe. What a tandem that was.
Corciani here tonight.
Oh, he is?
Yeah, Chris Corciani's here.
Wow.
Another turnover. They've coughed it up 5 times in their last 6 possessions, and Carolina can't stop the bleeding.
Point guard. You got to have point guard play. They don't have it.
Tokido with a jumper.
They have solid point guard play.
And look at them running again.
When you think of North Carolina, the point guards they've had over the years. I mean, you think about Raymond Felton. Ty Lawson has been unbelievable.
Hey, Tokido, one of the few bright spots tonight for North Carolina.
Yeah, you know, and I'm not going to diminish what he's doing, but it's a little easier to score when you're down 61-37 than in a pressure situation.
Leslie into Howell. And McAdoo down with a loose ball.
Well, the one thing I'll say is the kids have played hard. Not like we saw last year when they got beat by Florida State when we were down there.
Davis with a nice feed into Simmons for the layup.
Good look by Davis. Transfer out of Gardner-Webb.
Two guys who don't get a ton of playing time, but they're in there right now because none of the other guys are doing what Roy Williams wants them to do.
Well, here's Montross, former player in a championship team in 93. Told us he's a scholarship player.
Yep. Transferred from Gardner-Webb, sat out last year, is on scholarship, only playing sparingly for Carolina this year. Warren rebound Bullock, and he throws it away.
Lorenzo Brown wanted to post up inside against Davis. Nice pass. Unselfish, good interior passer. Share the rock, baby. Give the rock to your teammate. Take a high percentage shot, and you got a chance to win.
All NC State here tonight, and some of their former greats are loving it here. Chris Corciani, there he is, in a red sweater here, looking on. Great point guard in his day. And one of the best, David Thompson, is in the building tonight. Steve, thank you. We mentioned Chris Corciani. We told you David Thompson was here. The guy in the white shirt was blocking him when we went to break, so we couldn't show
him.
But there's David Thompson, one of the all-time greats.
If I had to pick five guys, my best 5 college players I've watched over the years, he would be one of the 5. As a college player, he was in another world.
Over the 1974 national champions here as Joel James gets the roll. Tyler Lewis is into the game for the first time. A 5'11 freshman out of Statesville, North Carolina. That's him with the ball, the backup point guard to Lorenzo Brown.
James is going to be a good player. If he listens to the coaching staff, he's going to be a good player. He can't lose faith, confidence. He's just got to keep listening to them and working because he's got a great, great physique.
Battle for the ball, and it's out of bounds to the Wolfpack.
I just think of him mentally about my top five of all time, not just here in Carolina, but of all time. I mean, you got to talk about Kareem, Luol Cinda as a center. You got to think about, you know, Larry Bird as a small forward, not bad. David as a forward, Thompson. And then I think about big guards. I got two guards. You may disagree. Based on the college, I'm going Jerry West and Oscar Robertson. Okay. Those five guys are in my all-time college fives of all time.
Michael and Magic coming off the bench.
Not bad.
You could win that game, Coach. I like your chances.
What about Maravich? What about Maravich? Yep. Calvin Murphy, pound for pound, as a collegian, was as good as anybody.
Luke Davis still in the game. Haven't seen Page in a while. Strickland in the backcourt with him.
Maravich was like going to watch a rock concert.
Kick ball, and they'll reset the shot clock to 15. And now here comes Page back into the game. Davis goes out.
They got to get Page on the right track because he's going to be too important to this team if they're going to win games. He was such a great high school player, but it's a big adjustment, the speed, the physical ability. You know, originally when he thought he was coming here, he thought maybe he'd play behind Marshall.
Right.
I mean, here it is, now you're thrown right to the woods. You talk about Lawson, you talk about Felton, you talk about Marshall. They're going to be a share of great point lines.
Bullock off the glass. Follow is there. Both James and Simmons were there. And James, I believe, got credit for the basket.
Look at James. He's playing hard, man. Give the kid. He's playing hard. Limited in skills. Hasn't played a whole lot of basketball.
Warren again.
He just absolutely has that nose to score. Has the touch as well.
Sneaks up on you. He's got 15. And again, the shooting percentage, as it often is terrific for TJ Warren.
Yeah, and the free throw line, it's a disaster. He shoots under 50%.
James, will he try to take Howell? And he does. Jumper over Howell.
He looks pretty good to me. Nice little touch right there.
Lewis, the guy who hasn't played a whole lot. Minutes down recently. Averaging about 10 minutes per game, about 2 points per game for State. There's the backdoor cut they like so much on that high post feed. That's the second time in a row that Carolina has sniffed it out.
Carolina cannot go on a spurt. Can't go on a spurt against NC State. It's very difficult to get back in the game if you can't make things happen defensively to give you offense. Defense to create offense.
Brown back in. Leslie back in.
I'm going to do this. I mentioned it on Twitter, and I got all kinds of responses. In a few minutes, I'm going to lay on them the five best players that I would take in the state of North Carolina that have played college basketball in Carolina. Just Carolina, my five best. And I know many of you will disagree. Some will agree, and it's one heck of a team.
So one of them's in the building tonight. We already,
yeah, one
that,
is in
that
the building.
That guy's on the team, right?
Absolutely.
Right.
He's on the team. You can send me a little tweet about it. Let me know if you like it or don't. Your Twitter/Dickie V. I get my tweets from Mr. Schumann, D. Schumann, yes. Underline, ESPN.
And believe me, if you send something to Dick on Twitter, he'll see it. He loves Twitter.
Twitter helps me raise a lot of money for the V Foundation. That's one of the reasons I love Twitter.
NC State. Let's check in with Shannon.
Well, Dick, you couldn't have set me up any better for this report. Speaking of Twitter, one of the former NC State players who actually was on that 03 team when they beat both Carolina and Duke in the same season in-house, Julius Hodge. He tweeted, if you're a UNC fan, unfollow me for the next few days after tonight's win. It won't be pleasant, and I will boast heavily.
At least he's being honest, huh?
Came out of New York City. He was a very versatile player. They were sitting around the floor, had a little NBA journey.
You know, when one team hasn't beaten another team in 13 straight, which is the case here, if they can win this one tonight, there will be a lot of boasting from NC State fans. James with another bucket for the Heels.
I'm going to tell you this stuff. I don't think these fans should rush the court. It's become a vogue now. Everywhere, rush the court, rush the court. You're ranked nationally. Have a little pride in yourself. No way does this warrant them rushing the court.
Agreed.
Yeah, sure.
Agreed. Remember, preseason, NC State was picked to win the ACC, not Carolina, not Duke. Big expectations for this team. Good defense by James, just standing up Brown. And here comes Carolina.
So one of the positives for North Carolina is going to play with James.
Page on the penetration right now.
Yes.
First field goal of the night.
I'm really happy for the kid. Maybe they'll get him going a little bit. Oh, up to the air, Jam City. Julius loves it. Mr. Hodge says, that's what I used to play, baby.
Strickland for three.
People at St. Pat's, Elizabeth. Like the kid Gilchrist's territory. Colin Irving. What is Irving doing? It's unbelievable.
He's one of the All-Star game.
40 to 35, and he ought to be a junior in college. A junior in college.
Brown into Leslie. Brown, seven assists already tonight. The seventh coming on that alley-oop to Warren. Leslie left it short. Strickland right into the chest of Wood, draws the foul, and will be at the free throw line when we come back.
Well, North Carolina's been run, baby, run. And there's the little diagonal, the alley-oop, there's the jam, and Julius Hodge in the crowd says, I love it, look, he knows the camera on him, he's a hot dog, he knows the camera's on him.
You got that right, Steve. Lorenzo Brown finding a lot of his teammates up above the rim, and NC State leading comfortably by 17. 7:09 to go. Brown with 16 points and 7 assists in this game.
He's been really unbelievable in creating tempo. He's created the pace of the game, got his teammates involved early, had that one unbelievable spurt where they put a show on running for layups.
We'll see another one of the nation's great point guards 1 week from tonight. Michigan at Indiana is our next game day game. So we'll see Trey Burke at Michigan and Bloomington taking on the Indiana Hoosiers. Could be, depending on what happens tomorrow, could be number one versus three or four, depending on how things go for those two schools, where they can both win tomorrow.
I wonder if John Green's going to be thinking about the Super Bowl Saturday night, because the next day is the Super Bowl. And as we all know, these two brother-in-laws are going to be going head-to-head.
And Mark Gottfried is second cousins with the Harbaughs. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I don't think Tom Crean's going to be thinking about the Super Bowl. He's going to be thinking about Burke and Hardaway.
Coach Gottfried's grandmother and Jim and John's grandmother were sisters. So
you got all these tickets. So was he trying to get tickets now? As he said, he didn't get a family in 30 years, and now Gottfried's trying to get tickets.
Leslie with another basket.
I left a message for Tom Crean. I said, Tom, I've been good to you over the years. I only want 8 tickets, 40-yard line.
That's all.
And I want cops.
A three for P.J. Hairston, who hasn't played a whole lot tonight. He does have 10 points now, but he's only been in there for about 11 or 12 minutes. Carolina, meanwhile, has it down to 14.
Well, he can shoot the three. He and Bullock, if they can go on a little spurt. You got to play defense, though. You got to stop them defensively. I'll tell you one thing. The Carolina kids have four back. James has given them solid minutes inside. They need some of those threes to four. Find the three ball for Hairston.
Here comes Bullock off a screen. He'll take one. And he can
shoot it. He can shoot it. It's down to 11. It's down to 11. You know, you saw that Wake Forest game. They were up big. NC State and Wake Forest came back and stole that game, but found a way to win. There's a lot of time left on his clock.
There is.
Especially with the three ball.
Mark Gottfried will use a timeout. The Tar Heels hitting back-to-back threes, and they've cut a 28-point deficit to 11.
And a huge game for that man. And, of course, a huge game for North Carolina.
Fells on a break with authority. 15 for Fells. Long three. Lawson doesn't get it. Rebound McCauley. North Carolina State is upset number three, North Carolina. Hold on, partner.
That was the last time that NC State defeated Carolina. Since then, the Tar Heels have won 13 in a row in this series. And that is the second longest losing streak that NC State has ever had against an ACC opponent. They're trying to snap it tonight, and for a while looked like that would be no problem at all. They were up by as many as 28, but Mark Gottfried wearing out those sneakers, doing a little pacing right now because Carolina's made seven straight shots, and they've got it down to 11.
I tell you, the guy sitting next to him was quite a coach. Bobby Lutz,
yes,
did a great job at Charlotte. Should be a head coach somewhere again. Got it down to 11. Right now, they got to get a little offense going. Turnover. Turnover. I mean, there's a spark in that bench now. Look at that bench jumping down there in North Carolina. Bobby Lutz trying to cheer him on. The bench standing up.
And a lot of time left in this game.
A lot of time, especially with the three ball. It gives you momentum. And that's what's happened here with Bullock and Hairston. That is some screens.
Page got all the way to the rim and got fouled by Brown.
That's a pretty good move there because now it puts you on the free throw line. It shuts down the clock. You can get it to single digits.
And Brown probably yelling, where's the help defense? Everybody caught napping for State.
He's got to convert on a free throw line here.
80% on the season.
This would be incredible. You don't have a comeback. It looked like they had no shot. No shot. They're down to 10. They were 28 down, Dan.
It wasn't that long ago. They were 28 down exactly 8 minutes ago with 13:22 to go. They've cut 19 points off the deficit in 8 minutes.
And I'm going to start with my full material. I'm talking about my five best players, five best in the state of North Carolina.
Hang on.
Now, right now, we got to go back to strategic. Chatting. Full court trap. Got to post up someone.
Leslie helping out here. Nice find. Warren with the finish. Boy, you can't do it any better than that.
Did a terrific job. Handling the ball, creating the opportunity, the numbers. That was a big possession.
Bullock gets a tough layup to go.
Reggie Miller's got some skills. Offensively, he can shoot the three, he can take it to the goal. North Carolina State has not been able to stop him in the last 7-8 possessions. They got to come up with a defensive stop right now. Stay in front of Brad. Page is going to try to stay in front of him.
Leslie slips inside and finishes.
CJ Leslie takes his game to another level. Stage on. Show is on him. And cut the lead. Look at what. A little happy there with the effort they made to get back. A little respectability. CJ, two plays in a row. He's made two excellent plays. Kept the pivot foot on the floor.
All right. Mark Gottfried helped you out here. He called the timeout, so give us your top five players who have ever played for a Carolina school.
Okay, we're going to talk about my top five. We're going to go to the backcourt. My backcourt, nobody played the point better than Phil Ford. Second guard, score a machine, Michael Jordan. And what about my front court? Are you kidding? David Thompson, Christian Leighton, and Tim Duncan. Give me a better five. Who would you take off that five?
I don't know.
When I was on Twitter, guys would say, oh, no, I would take this guy. And there's so many great
players. You must have heard some James Worthy. You must have heard some Grant Hill. I mean, there's so many. Yeah.
And they're all great players.
Yep.
Bob Hurley. Heard about all those guys. But David, you are a unanimous selection. David is unanimous. I don't forget Norm Sloan. Jimmy V told me a story. He said he goes for a haircut in the barbershop when he first came here. And the barber turned on him and said, hey, another team that they had, Norm Sloan with David Thompson, they did a pretty good job. But can you imagine what Dean Smith would have done with that team?
Wide open, misses the three. Boy, that would have been huge for the Heels.
Now you get down to shot selection, free throw shooting, and that's been an Achilles heel for NC State.
Wood. Yes.
That's big. That's big. Took it in the crowd. That's big. That's a dagger, man. That's a dagger. That's a big, big shot. Comes off that little curl move, steps out to the three. He can flat out shoot the trifecta. And you don't want to foul him late in the game. He's one of the premier free throw shooters in all of college basketball.
That was his 280th three. He's on pace to possibly surpass Rodney Monroe as NC State's all-time leader in three-point field goals.
They had some backcourt together. You talk about a tandem when you had Corciani to Monroe, Corciani's penetration ability.
Shot clock issue right now is what has caused the stoppage.
how quickly that went from 10 to 15. Bam, bam, bam.
Four-point play by Scott Woody. He can be quiet for a while, but boy, you leave him open for a sliver, and he'll knock it down.
See, I think there's room for a kid like that for next level. He needs some offense off the bench. Come in, spot shooter.
Zone look here by State.
Yeah, went to the zone.
Well, slow him down a little, take some time off the clock.
I like that strategic roll down, Schubert. You are right. See, it makes him work a little harder. Hits him a shot. Momentum has now swung again. Momentum has come back to State.
And Purvis will be at the free throw line when we come back.
Little Uncle Mo went the way of North Carolina, but now Uncle Mo is on the side of State.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by DirecTV. Don't just watch TV, DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Until then, we continue here in Raleigh. 16-point lead now for the Wolfpack as we check in again with Shannon Spear.
Coach Gottfried continuing to get his guys pumped up in the huddle, guys. He just said to him during that timeout, we did not come to play North Carolina. We came here to beat them. That was the message.
And Carolina got it down to 9 just a couple of minutes ago, Dick, but all of a sudden it's back up to 17.
What a momentum has gone the way of NC State. I think one of the reasons was the play of C.J. Leslie in that one little spurt that they had. You know, Dan, they shoot 51% as a team, which is third in the nation, NC State. And tonight, they're shooting about 50%.
And always so balanced. Tonight, Warren with 19. Leslie has 17. Brown has 16. Howell has 14. Typical NC State.
It's amazing with the 19 with Warren. That's been a quiet 19. Yeah. I mean, he is unbelievable.
Well, he's got Lorenzo Brown to thank for a few of those buckets. Here comes Leslie back into the game. State, as we mentioned, they've got 5 players in double figures. Purvis is at 9.9. And they've got 4 1,000-point scores on the team, the only Division I team that can say that.
Yeah, Brown recently became the 48. He also has 10 assists here tonight.
Dueling turnovers, and the Wolfpack line up with the ball again.
I can see why Coach K said in transition, he's as good as a point guard you're going to see.
They've got 34 fast break points tonight.
And he's created most of them. He beats you off the bounce, gives you numbers. And right there, he beat Page, goes to the basket. Bad shot right there.
Shot clock did not reset. Now it hits the rim, but Carolina comes down with the ball. Nice ball movement, and Bullock lays it in.
That was really a classic fast break drill layup. Tremendous job in transition, moving the ball. And that's the one area that they've done an excellent job tonight, North Carolina State, getting back defensively.
Another great pass, Brown to Howell.
They're going to miss that guy when he leaves here. Lorenzo Brown.
11 assists for Brown. Hairston with a 3, timeout Carolina. Lorenzo Brown had 13 assists in the win over Duke 2 weeks ago. He's got 11 here tonight. He is the ACC leader in assists at about 7 a game.
Lorenzo Brown show, baby. Good vision. There's the pass off the bounce. He's got guys that can finish. There's the dunk off. Good high. See, look at the young kids. Heads up. Spin move to the goal. Lorenzo Brown shows he can shoot the distant 3 as well. I tell you what, this is a great clip to send the NBA scouts. He's done it all here in that sequence. He's done it all in that tape.
Big Monday presented by Bud Light begins with Pittsburgh and Louisville at 7 Eastern. Of the Cardinals losing at Georgetown today. They'll be feisty Monday night. Looking to snap a 3-game losing streak. And then Kansas, which defeated Oklahoma today, is into Morgantown to take on to West Virginia at 9 Eastern. A big Monday presented by Bud Light on ESPN and also on Watch ESPN.
Well, you look at Luke McGillisdale. They're a couple of plays away from being number one in the nation. Mm-hmm. Lost a heartbreaker to Syracuse. Lost a heartbreaker to overtime to Villanova. And lost a heartbreaker today. I think it's three people panicking. Oh, shocks, upsets. Come on, man. They don't have a lot of upsets. Not when you're winning away, losing away from home in unbelievable environments against good teams. I think that's so overrated. I mean, Minnesota losing to Wisconsin. Is that a shot?
Losing by one.
Kansas right. State up at Iowa State. Yep. Georgetown, Louisville.
Hairston misses the three.
Villanova's put themselves in a great position. They're going to be my team of the week. I can't see anybody having a better week than they've had. They've only beaten Louisville and beaten Syracuse.
Yes, Jay Rice, but his team playing well right now.
A year earlier than what they anticipated.
Brown lost it on the way up, but it's ruled that it was knocked out of bounds. It'll still be Wolfpack ball. Point lead, 2:11 to go. The lead was as great as 28 earlier this half, and Carolina got it down to 9 before State stretched it out a bit. Leslie, and a travel. With a win tonight, NC State will go to 5-2 in ACC play. Their next game is at Virginia on ESPN2 on Tuesday. Then they're home to Miami next week, and the Hurricanes, the leaders in the conference right now, as Page knocks down a three.
That's a good-looking three right there by Page.
ESPN College Basketball is available live anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone at watchESPN.com and with the Watch ESPN app. And tonight's game and all the Saturday primetime games the rest of the season can be seen in stunning 3D on the ESPN 3D network.
Wow, we've seen a 3D?
3D.
3D?
That might be one more D than anybody wants of us.
Hey, I'll tell you this as well. You know, you think about NC State, you mentioned they'll be 5-2 after tonight's conference play. They're a player two away from being 7-0.
Yes.
I mean, Lynn beats them at the end on the tip with Maryland, and then they lose by 2 to Wake Forest. So, I mean, think about how close they are to being 7-6.
The upcoming schedules, we mentioned at Virginia Tuesday night on ESPN2. Big game against Miami next Saturday, and then going to Duke on the 7th of February. NC State will move to 5-2. Miami leading the conference at 5-0 with a loss tonight. Carolina with a fall to 3-3. They're going to Boston College on ESPNU Tuesday night.
Talk about a guy getting the most out of his people. And to me, that's a true definition of a coach. Tony Bennett down in Virginia.
Yes. Scott Wood with another three.
Gotta allow him to shoot the three. He squares his body. Count it.
Tokido knocks down a mid-range jumper at the other end.
You know, Tokido and certainly James show a lot of potential. Bryce Johnson.
It's a young, young team. They've won 3 in a row coming into this game tonight.
CJ Leslie has a pretty good handle for a big guy.
Got pushed. And now taken away by Bullock. They're letting him play. Numbers for the heels. And Tokido finishes again.
That was great body control right there by Tokido. Really excellent body control.
And another timeout taken by Roy Williams. Well, 2 weeks ago, NC State knocked off then number one Duke here at PNC Arena, 84-76, the sixth all-time win against a number one team for the Wolfpack. CJ Leslie at 25, Richard Howell, 16 points, 18 rebounds, Lorenzo Brown in a big game. They rushed the court, and they celebrated big time then. With more, here's Shannon.
Well, Dan, I spoke with the NC State student body president. He told me that he does not think there's any plan to storm the court here today. He told me it's not going to happen. But the general manager of the arena, I caught up with him, asked him the protocol, how they handle it. There are about 30 extra security guards that have started to make their way out here, people that work for the arena. They tell the students which way they should make their way out into the court, organized chaos of sorts. But I can see the security guards and the folks that work at the arena making their way out here right now.
Hey, can I become an agent? I want to be your agent and Shannon's. Because I'm telling you, you both are going big time. I'll be long gone. You're going big. Oh, I want the rock. I want the rock.
Almost got it.
She's done a terrific job at SCN. Saturday game day.
At NASCAR during most of the year, joining us the last couple of weeks, again next Saturday up in Bloomington, Indiana. Meanwhile, a State turnover. Crowd's a little restless. The Wolfpack haven't quite been able to put this one away yet. Hairston with a three. It's a 7-point game, and Roy Williams. Williams will use his last timeout.
You know, Dean Smith had so many miraculous finishes at the end. Did a phenomenal job when he was at North Carolina, winning games that you thought were over. There's Hairston shooting that three. Great screen to get him free for that three.
I'll tell you, State may win it, but Mark Gottfried is an unhappy man right now.
Well, they have a 28-point lead, but you got to credit right now. Will Prevent, look at him. He's a young guy, a real shooter.
He was part of the court storming a couple of weeks ago against Duke.
You know, you got to credit North Carolina for making plays here and getting back to this game. They have strapped, they have fought, and it made the three. Doing what we know they can do. Shoot the three, get up and down in transition.
Look at this environment, though. Look at what's happened here in the last couple of years. They got another great recruiting class coming in. You talked about it. Julian Randle is here tonight. One of the top incoming players next year, taking his official visit here in Raleigh tonight. This program is on the map.
He's also being recruited heavily in his home state of Texas and also by a school down in Lexington called Kentucky.
They tend to get their fair share.
People are going to have fun with Kentucky this year because I'm telling you, my friends, it's lights out next year.
And they're still in on Andrew Wiggins as well, the top-rated player in the ESPN 100. He is yet to commit for next year.
I saw him playing. He's everything they say and more.
Down in Florida?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Explosive. Terrific talent. Great young guy, too. Spoke to him. His mom and dad were great athletes, Canadian as well.
Thank you.
I know you were ready to write it down for me.
Next game's next, coming up on
ESPN.
He's
not like John Saunders now. John is
Come
the
on, John.
Guy. You and John. John used to be Country John. When he was dad's first starting in Canada. Here it is. Got to dig in. Got to foul him. Let him go to a foul him.
Lorenzo Brown.
He's happy because his kids didn't fold the tent. Yep. Didn't fold the tent.
One more foul to put NC State at the line.
And you want to put him on the line. But what do you know, poorest free throw shooting teams.
They'd rather not put Brown on the line. They'd probably rather put Warren on the line, and they might get their chance.
Should have had him. Should have had him right there. Boy. Too much time to that.
Wasted 2-3 seconds, and Roy Williams just yelled, "What are you doing?"
He's a 48% shooter versus Brown, and you certainly don't want to foul Wood. He iced the game against Clemson. He hit the line. Made 5 free throws in the last 27 seconds.
Warren Purvis. Warren and Purvis are the guys on the floor. The two guys, maybe Howell as well. You want to stay away from Wood and you want to stay away from Brown. Warren at the line, as Dick mentioned, 49%. This is 1-1.
Not close. Not close. You got to push it up the court. Push up the court. Look for a three. Set the screen. Shoot it right there.
In and out for Bullock. McAdoo the follow. A 5-point game.
It's amazing. There's still time. With a 5-point deficit, there is time. They were down 28. And they have just taken it up another level here at the end of the game. This baby looks like it's in. And there's the good offensive rebound by McAdoo. You got a foul right away, Dan. You got a foul right away.
Mike Eads and Mike Stewart, two of the officials, have gone to look at the monitor after that play.
About time, you think?
Yeah, maybe some time ran off after the basket.
Well, the clock stops after the score in the last minute. See, the clock should have stopped. They got to put 30 on that clock. 30.
Put a few tenths of a second back on. And they do. They go up to 30.7, or 8 tenths of a second. Roy will take all he can get. Carolina's out of timeout. State is scuffling to get to the finish line here.
You want to get the ball in the hands of Brown or Wood.
Yeah.
You want to get it to Brown or Wood to get him to the free throw line. Set a screen for Wood, popping the ball. And a hold. Hold on Wood.
On Wood, and that's not what Bullock wanted to do. And working hard to try to prevent Wood from getting the ball, he fouled him before the ball got there.
Yeah, that was a good call, though. Good call. He definitely had him.
91% on the season.
Nice story with the ball. Think about that, 91%. It's nice having this kind of guy on your team late in the game with the lead.
And even better lately, he's made 30 36 of his last 38.
How'd he miss two? Take the scholarship away from him.
Again, 1-1. Wolfpack trying to sort out their defensive responsibilities. It looked like this one was going to be a cakewalk most of the night for the Wolfpack, but Carolina has put a little pressure on him here in the closing minutes.
That was blowout city. They were down 28. But Carolina picked it up, played with some heart and guts, and got back in the game. Made it respectable. Really hurts when you're battling back and foul a kid like this, and he just goes to the line and he puts two in the book. It's two in the book. 38 to 40. Gotta push up the court, Marcus.
Page misses a three.
It's over. It's academic now. It's over. The 13-game streak comes to an end. 13 in a row. They have lost to Chapel Hill. They have Chapel Carolina Blue. But the Big Red will celebrate tonight, Dan Schumann.
And McAdoo has fouled out. Never really got a chance to get it going tonight. Didn't play very much in the first half. Picked up two early fouls.
Got two like in the first 2 minutes. Yep. There were spots in this game where North Carolina State was absolutely dominated. Dominated. And then they went to a little slot, and I think that's one of the things they got to be concerned about. They had a nice lead also in Wake Forest, and they let it get away from them.
But talent-wise, they can compete with anybody.
You're right.
There's Will Privet.
Played Michigan tough up at Ann Arbor. Lost the game by seven, but it was a tough game.
Yeah, two-point game with a minute to go in Ann Arbor. Can they bring it every night, though? Can they be consistent?
That's a sign of greatness. A sign of grace. Greatness is to do it on a regular basis. Wow.
Hairston, another three.
He can flat out shoot the three.
And they'll foul Brown one more time. X Games are coming from Aspen as soon as this one is over. The 13-game Carolina winning streak over NC State, as Dick mentioned, is 9.3 seconds away from being history.
Well, they did what they had to do. Come back home and get a win after losing to Wake Forest. Just two of the last three after beating North Carolina. It'll be interesting to see now how they react after this win.
Right.
Because they're 1-13 after wins over North Carolina and Duke.
Virginia Tuesday night. Tough team, tough place. You know it's going to be a much different game. A defensive, grind it out kind of game. Yeah. And then they come, then their next two after that, home against Miami, and then they go to Duke. A tough stretch coming for NC State.
Well, you know, people talk about you and all the expectations. Everybody on cloud nine went to the Sweet 16 last year. People talked about them being the class of the ACC. You're going to want to win those games. You're going to win those games if you're that good. Page came back and had some good minutes at the end here. Had a tough start. Well, they're ready to celebrate. They're ready to celebrate.
And it's official. NC State knocks off North Carolina for the first time in 7 years, and it's the first time in 10 years they have defeated both Duke and Carolina in the same regular season. 91-83, the final here at PNC Arena in Raleigh, as the Wolfpack go to 5-2 in league play. For the Faisal, Shannon Spake, and our entire crew, I'm Dan Schulman saying thanks for watching tonight. Live coverage of the X Games Aspen continues right now. Here's Ramona Brulin.